The record is starting. Yeah, great. So probably it is a little bit early, but we will start just to see if everything is working well. Go live. So the process has started and we are connecting Zoom and Facebook, and hopefully all these new technologies will help us, because today and all these months we are trying to use digital instruments for connection, and that's amazing that we have these instruments to start communication, even being in different countries. So we will give our guests of our online stream some minutes to join us. And meanwhile, I would like to take an attention to Arte Laguna website and to tell some words about pre-application process. That is very important, because now it is a possibility to apply with the discounts, and that's good, because for artists it is very useful information when they can apply with discounts. So it will be already 15th edition of Arte Laguna, and the exhibition in 2021 will be as usual in Venetian Arsenale. And it will be the great exposition where the finalists of 14th and 15th edition will be presented together. And it will be like a great, great, great event in the international art sphere. So I invite everybody to take part in this big event, in the opening that we are waiting so much. And hopefully all of you can see the my screen now, and as you can see, pre-applications are now open, and for those artists who are deciding to participate, I pay attention that on the website artelaguna.world and Arte Laguna Prize, you can find all the information, all the details, everything that will be very useful for you to apply. And some words about the artistic disciplines. Here we have painting, we have photography art, we have sculpture and installation, we have video art and short films, we have performance, we have digital art, digital graphics and cartoon, land art, urban art and street art, and design art. So if you are a creator, if you are an artist and you're working in these different mediums, you can participate with up to 5 projects to Arte Laguna Prize, and take a chance of showing everything that you do during your artistic practice. And I think that you should be interested, because, for example, being a designer, you can also show your sketches, you can also show your photography, and it can help to show all the angles, all the directions of your artistic work. And here I have some double sound. We will try to put it off. Yeah, so Arte Laguna World, and this is the platform where all our artists, all our finalists have the possibility to show their artworks, as for example, you can see here. And I'm starting to present to the audience the guest of today, Yuan Gao, and her beautiful partner in work and in life, Pan Li. Yeah, we can see them, and they are joining us from China. Am I right?
Yes, in Beijing.
In Beijing, yeah, perfect. I'm Anna Schwetz, from Russia, from Moscow, and we have wonderful summer day here. hope everybody who are joining us have a wonderful day too. And as you can see, now we are on Arte Laguna World platform. And from here, we can start to meet our guest. And as you can see, she lives and works in China, born in China. And she is very young. I mean, you can be young in whatever age you want, but you are 34, right?
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, that's great. And here we can see your artworks, and we will see them more in detail later on. And first of all, I would like to stop sharing screen to give possibility to our audience to see your faces. And the first question is, tell us please about your experience in applying to Arte Laguna. And was it difficult? Was it difficult for you to choose what artworks to present? What description to make to them? Was it difficult or easy for you to fill the form? And what were your emotions when you found out that this pandemia and global lockdown stopped all of us from seeing each other in a real art show in Arsenale of Venice? And what is your opinion about the fact that we decided to do this online meetings on a regular basis? And I will continue with the next questions later. Please, your word.
Okay, let me introduce my partner first. She's Tan Li, and she makes the music, the sound in the animation, and she is the actor in it too. And she will help me to translate my words into English, because all I can say is that's all. 然后我回答这个问题。 就是这其实是我第三次申请拉古纳大赛了。So to answer this question, this is actually the third time I applied for Arte Laguna Prize.
Wow, great! And third time is a happy time.
Yeah, of course. 就是其实第一次是我自己申请的，很多年前申请的。第二次和第三次都是。 江南上海帮我做的申请资料。So the first time I applied totally on my own, but that was many years ago. The second time and third time was last year and this year, right? Yeah, I applied with the great help by the gallery I'm working on, Capsule Shanghai. It's a gallery located in Shanghai. So with their help, they with all the materials for application, I did the letter two times.
By the way, we were speaking today with your gallerist, and he's very satisfied with work that you do, and he's very happy for you and send you felicidades, congratulations with the prize. That's important. It's important, this collaboration of the gallerist and the artist, and you are very lucky, and that's fantastic. Yes.
Thank you. 然后就是当时不是听说这个比赛要暂停推迟，当时甚至想有可能会取消吗？ 但是就是我们知道这个消息的时候，并没有特别失望或者意外，因为其实那个时候我们更关注的是意大利的疫情，我们每天都还挺担心那边的情况的。So at first, when the pandemic started, we learned about the possible postpone or even perhaps canceling of the Laguna Prize. We were not as surprised at the change of plan in traveling, as we were concerned about the pandemic situation in Italy. We watch and read news every day following what's going on, So we really cared about the situation there. Yeah. 但是后来就知道这个这个大赛还是恢复了，而且居然最后我还能拿到这个奖，这是完全出乎意料，非常的惊喜，根本没有想到。And then later we learned that the Our Laguna Prize is going to continue, but going online. Instead, we were surprised. And it's totally out of my expectation that when I heard my name as a winner, I didn't expect it at all.
Uh-huh. And I will remind those guests of our online stream who are just joining us, that we are here with Yuan Gao, who won the prize in video art section. And that's fantastic because she's amazing and she's super talented. She's from China, she's 34, and she worked with her live and work partner, Pan Li. And a little bit later, we will see the episode from this cartoon, from this animated story, and that is fantastic. And my next question is, was it difficult or easy to decide with artwork to participate?
Oh, 因为我做的是动画，我每一个作品周期是非常长的，所以其实选择什么作品参加对我来说不难。
Because I dedicate to animation making, and each project of mine took a really long period to complete. So for the project I'm working on right now, it's also a long-term one. So it's not very difficult for me to choose what works to submit to Art Laguna Prize because it's all connected to one project.
Ah, yes, amazing. So now I want to show to our guests of our online stream some images. And we will start from, let's say, from still images. Let me share my screen, just a second. And if you have any comments, we would be great for these comments. So what we can see now, those are the parts of the artwork of this movie, or these are separate works?
这些场景它都是我每一张都是我单独的架上绘画，他们最后在动画里面是被连成一体。
So each of these paintings, they are independent paintings on canvas as painting works, but they also, all of them serve as background settings in my animation film.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let me show different images just to go deeper in your imaginary world. And it's fantastic in my mind. Yeah, very, very atmospheric and bright colors. And you work with acrylic, right?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And is it your favorite medium?
对，因为丙烯它是综合了水彩和油画的特点，它很方便，也很便利。
Yes, because acrylic is kind of between watercolor and oil paints, so it has brighter colors. My favorite medium.
Yeah, it's very beautiful. It's very beautiful what you are doing. Uh-huh. And how many years you already working in animation movies, making animation movies?
我大学学的就是动画专业，所以从大学到现在一直都是在做这个动画。
Because I studied animation arts in college, so since then I've been working on animation nonstop till nowadays.
Wow, so like 20 years, more or less.
Not that long.
15 years. Wow, amazing. Okay, yeah, that's fantastic. Let me try to, let me try to show the video. I don't know if online streaming will let us this possibility, but we will try. We have a video here. Let me try to start it. And dear guests of this online streaming, if the video will be slow, you can find the trailer on the Arte Laguna social networks, and you can really appreciate it. Okay, let me share the screen. Okay, great. And let's try. And it's very, very visually beautiful and romantic.
Thank you.
Wow. So, Cloud of Unknown. Can you please tell us more about the concept of this artwork, about this movie, I would say? And who is this lady and why it is this title to this? Okay.
好，这个会比较长，就是其实我现在是在做一个动画长片，一个故事长片，然后这个短片，其实是故事长片的一个概念，就是它本身是有它完整的叙事的，但是它也是我正在做的长片的一个片段。
So this answer might be a bit long. First of all.I am at the moment working on a feature animation film, and this short film Cloud of the Unknown is actually a concept short film for the feature film, but it has in itself a complete narrative, but it's also a part of the feature film.
Uh-huh. And the duration of the film is 90 minutes, right? We saw
yes.
just the trailer. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. 就是这个故事它是从我的一个想象中来的，就是梦不是一时的折射，梦中的世界是真实存在的，是一个平行于我们的时空，然后我们在里面经历的是另一个世界的我们真正的人生。
So the inspiration for this story comes from an imagined hypothesis of mine, that I thought dreamsare not simply the reflection of our consciousness. They are actually parallel time space that truly exists. So what we experience in our dreams are very probably the life, the actual life of different versions of ourselves.
然后我会有这样的想法，是因为不管是从我阅读哲学啊文学啊这些书籍上，还是从我个人的感受，就是不，我觉得不管人们活了多长的时间，其实呢生命它是没有办法自己去证实它的真实性的，就是你不管活了多久都没有办法证明生命不是一个幻觉。
So the reason why I would think this way is because either fromall the philosophical or literary works that I've read, or from my personal experiences, I've realized that no matter how long one has lived, one can never really prove that life isn't illusory. So,
Interesting. I have a question.
Okay.
How long did you work on this 90 minutes of this animated story? How long was the process?
Oh,
you mean the script?
I mean everything, all the work on this animated story.
It's still in working.
So I
can't really envision how long exactly it will take, probably years, but it depends on how smoothly it goes.
And you're already working more than 1 year on this, right?
Before I actually worked on this short film, I already spent 1 or 2 years writing the script for the feature film. And then I started with this short film, and then now I'm moving on to the feature.
Oh, yeah, that's fantastic. And who is this girl? And why is she so magnetic, so enigmatic? She has many secrets?
这个女孩就是我的主人公啊。至于她有什么秘密，我现在还不能说。对，这是我的长篇要讲的故事。So
this girl is the main character in my feature film. She has a lot of secrets, as you said, but I'm not going to spoil the story by telling you what her secrets are.
Okay. So the question from our guests, when and where it will be possible to see the whole movie, not just a trailer?
是说短片对吧？ Short film?
For the short film or for the feature?
The short film will be...
Both. When we can
see it. 就可以在洛江诺的那个在线看，其实。
Well, recently this short film is attending, it's part of Locarno Film Festival 2020. So it will be screened during August the 5th to August the 15th in Switzerland. All over the country, right? Yeah, and it can also be seen online, but you might be checking with Locarno's website to see their
schedule. 就是在八月，应该是五到十五号，会在洛江诺的官网上可以知道怎么去看这个片子。它会有一个观看人数的上限，但是在那个上限之前，大家都是可以去看。Okay,
so they have a limit for for the number of audiences allowed to see online at one time. So if anyone wants to see the short film, you may need to check with Locarno's website to see if you still can book.
I'm just curious about how to see the whole version, and I think that our guests will also be interested to see this video and this movie. Okay, Locarno Film Festival, and let me name all the list. For example, your works already were presented in Shanghai, New York, Hong Kong, Stockholm, Beijing, Vancouver, Rotterdam, Leipzig. Why do you think it is so important for the artist, for an artist to be active?
我觉得争取尽量多的机会让作品可以让更多人看到，这是肯定需要的，因为 作品的能量，它是需要传递到他者的心灵中的时候，它才算是实现了自己的价值嘛。
I think it's definitely necessary to earn as many opportunities as possible to get your work seen by others, because it is only when the power that you implanted or you put into your work can be delivered or passed on to the audience's heart and mind, then we can say that the work has realized its values.
然后因为我做的这个算是 video art, 所以它其实在传播上是比较方便、比较有优势的。我不用必须自己去亲自去每次放映、每次去布展，所以这会让我有更多时间创作。
And for video art, it actually has the advantage to in spreading. So I don't always have to show up where my works are shown. So this kind of gives me more time in making art.
Ah, yeah, you're lucky in this case, because those who are doing paintings and sculptures, they are kind of blocked now. So you are very lucky. Yeah. Okay, ladies, I have a question about your daily art routine. What do you read? What do you do? I know you have 4 cats. Do they, do they help you in your daily art practice?
Oh.
I don't think they are helpful. But I really happy with them. 就是给我导读量可能更多吧。
They might interrupt my art making more than they help, but I'm very happy with them.
Okay, so share with us what books do you read? What movies do you watch to get inspiration?
Oh my god. 这是一个很难回答的问题。因为我是一个书呆子，我也看了很多很多的电影，有点不知道从何打起啊。
It's a difficult question because I'm kind of a book nerd. I read everything. I watch a lot of movies, so I don't know where to start.
然后其实我是因为看了非常多的书，我才开始。我在小时候我最开始的梦想其实是当作家，然后呢，因为各种原因我接触到了这个动画，为了学习好动画我就需要更了解电影，所以就让我需要看更多的电影。
So actually at first, because when I was small, I was already reading a lot of books. So at first my dream was to become a writer.
Wow.
And then, began to study animation arts, and to understand animation arts better, I started watching a lot of movies.
对，谢谢。
Okay.
我没有办法给出一个具体的。
It's not easy to give a like specific list of movies or books.
Okay. I have a question. And it is always interesting, what obstacles do you meet doing your work and presenting your work? It's important.
It's very long.
It's a long answer. She said she prepared, like she thought about this, well, it happens.
Please share your opinion, because I know that a lot of people around the world, they are watching us now, and probably they also meet some obstacles, and I know that you are brave, you work a lot. Please tell us your story.
Okay, 这个问题。对，虽然现在是全球的观众都有可能在看这个节目，但是，我可能不得不就是以在中国为前提来回答这个问题，因为中国不是一个正常的国家，就是不管从经济、政治还是社会有，都有大量的根本性的，就是结构性的问题在吧。
Although I know that our audiences are international.But for me to answer this question, I have to put the context in China as a premise, because that's what I know best. For us, this is not a very regular country. There are a lot of political, economical, and social problems, and they are all structural problems. They have been there all the time, and they are getting worse.
对，这些问题长期存在，而且是非常严重的。就是中国可能大多数人他一生都是没有办法去过自己想要的生活。
而且是大家也没有能力去改变自己的处境。
Many people here, most people here, they're not really able to live a life that they want to live, and they're too weak to change the environment.
然后我其实我从事艺术本身，这就是为了从这种压抑的环境中可以跳脱出来。包括我做艺术，我的创作的内容也是想要给别人一个不同的角度去看啊，生活还有别的可能性。生活不是只是现实这么糟糕的这个样子。
So part of the reason why I involve in art is because I want to get out of the environment, and by what I make in my art, I want to show people a different way, a different perspective to look at life, and to imagine more possibilities of living a life. And this is also the kind of rejection of the reality we are in.
那就我这个现在正在做的工作来说，我的主要困境也还是来自外部环境的。
So as to my current personal projects that I'm working on now, this feature film, the biggest obstacle also comes from the outside, comes from the environment.
就是像你刚才问到的这个女孩，这个我的片子里的主人公，她其实是个 lesbian， 就和我们一样。然后但是就是同性恋这个题材在中国的大荧幕上，它几乎是被禁止的。就是现在这些规定说的比以前好听了，就是说你可以表现同性恋，你只要就是表现他们是朋友一样就行了。
As I said, just now.This main character in my feature film, this girl with a lot of secrets, she's a lesbian, and the film tells a homosexual romance story. But this kind of stories are almost prohibited to be screened in the cinemas here in China. We say almost because they're like, you can show a queer story on the screen,but you have to fake them. You have to make them look like friends.
Yeah, 然后我是对这个接受这样的羞辱吧，就是什么我对接受这样的羞辱没有兴趣。
And I'm totally not interested in accepting this kind of humiliation.
而且就是其实还有很多别的规定也是我没有办法接受的，比如说必须要符合科学的解释，必须要正面，必须正能量，积极什么的。
And there are other regulations that I'm not interested in accepting. For instance, they said your story has to be able to be explained by science, or that you have definitely to pass on a very positive attitude message or something like that.
然后其实我现在在做的它毕竟是一个动画电影。动画电影最好的去处它应该还是电影院。中国有这么多动画爱好者，然后中国有这么多的 queer， 这么多藏起来的同性恋，大家其实应该是非常希望能在电影院看到和同性恋有关系的动画的。
So what I'm making is actually an animation film, and the best place for it is the cinemas or the theaters. And there are a lot of people here in China, they are keen about animation arts, and there are a very large number of queer people here, either apparent or not. They must want to see a queer animation film in the theater or in the cinema.
所以如果说因为这个规定的原因让我的作品最后没有办法在荧幕上和观众见面，那它不仅会对我现在完成这个作品有障碍，也其实也是对这个作品去发挥它的意义也是有障碍的。
So my film, when it's completed, it's not being able to be screened in the cinema, not only affects the making of it, but also it prevents the film.To meet the audiences that need to see it most badly, so the delivery of the message would be prevented in a way.
Yeah, and also it is a problem to open Facebook or social networks that people here are using, right?
Oh, we use regularly. We use VPN.
Yeah. I know what you're talking about, because, for example, in Russia, we don't have possibility to enter LinkedIn that all the world
connection.
So I can understand when you are kind of blocked, you are trying to find a way to express yourself, and you are very lucky being an artist to have possibility to put your ideas and dreams to the form of animated story. And we have questions here from Nevena, also one of the finalists. She writes, I just wanted to ask what your dreams look like.
Which one?
The bright.
Do you want her to like describe one of her dreams?
Like, look.
Okay. 就是比如说我会曾经梦到过一个路上碰到了一个人，这个人突然就跟我搭话，然后他跟我说，哎，你以前也梦见过我，你记不记得？
So just to give you one example,
yes.
One time I had a dream where I met someone I didn't know at all, and he said to me, oh, hey, you dreamt about me before. Do you remember me? Yeah, so that's really weird.
然后也曾经有就是不止一次的会在梦中有人告诉我这是梦，这是梦，这同时也是真的，就是类似这样的信息。
And I got messages in my dream from other people in my dream that they would tell me this is both a dream and a reality. More than once I had dreams like this.
Wow. So probably you have connection with other reality and you're taking messages. Wow, you're lucky.
Supernatural.
Yeah, actually, I think that all the artists have this skill to connect with other realities, to receive messages and to express them in your artworks. Yeah?
That's very possible.
Yeah. Okay. I have a question. The other question about your most strange art experiment.
Oh.
You have it?
应该说应该是其实应该是写剧本吧，就是写个两万字，然后唰全删了，然后再重新写。
I would say it's the writing of the scripts. It's like you finally write some 20,000 Chinese characters, and then you delete them, and then you rewrite, you keep rewriting.
然后在这个就是其实每一次重写的时候，就是写剧本呢，它是关于角色如何度过他们的人生的，它还不止一个角色嘛。那每一次重写，我都要重新去想象去扮演不同的人。
So the script is all about how all of these characters in your film, how they endure their life. And each time you write about these characters, you have to play the roles inside your mind. Mm-hmm. So I have played a lot of roles.
然后由于最后的定稿，尤其从定稿再到能够把它那个呈现到电影里的，永远只是一小部分，那么就有很多曾经写过的角色，他们就变成了幽灵一样的存在，就存在在作者的心里面。
And finally, you have your final drafts in the end, but you can only show a very small part of the whole work in your film. And there are a lot of characters and scenes and settings that are not selected into your film, and they would become some kind of ghosty beings haunting your mind.
Yeah.
对，所以这个可能不能算是一种很奇特的实验，但是它其实是很惊险。
So it might not be the most strange experiment, but it's really definitely some
a stunning experience, very strange experience.
Yeah. And I just realized that during your work doing animated movies, animated stories, you combine your initial desire to become a writer and drawings. So you're combining your passions in the medium that you selected, right?
把你想要当作家的这个写作的愿望和那个画画的爱好结合在一起了啊，对对对，正好说说这个，
yes.
你可以说说你大学看到这个，
嗯，对，就是，对，我是，我本来是想当作家的嘛，我刚才也有说过，但是呢，我在大学我本来应该要选的是文学或者是社会学方面专业。可是当时出了一点意外，我没有学成自己本来想学的专业。然后我在一个选修课上就偶然看到了很多日本大概90年代的那一批的动画。
I wish I could understand Chinese girls. I understand, but not in detail. Yeah. Translate.
Wow. Gaoyuan said, like I said before, I wanted to be a writer at first. And when I was going to college, I wanted to study literature or sociology at first. But something happened and I ended up in a major that I totally had no interest in. And at some elective course, I happened to see a few Japanese animation works from the 1990s. And they're so
这些动画就是它很晦涩，非常非常不好懂，它不是那种大众看的动画，但是它们非常的美，艺术水准非常高，也有很强的文学性。然后我当时一看就突然意识到啊，动画就像你刚才说的一样，是一个结合我的文学梦想和这个艺术梦想的一个非常好的地方。
So these Japanese film, animation films, they are not the very popular ones, not very easy to understand, but they have this very elusive and beautiful atmosphere, and they have very high level in aesthetics, and the way they tell the story is very literary. So I realized that if I study animation arts, then I can combine, like you said, combine these two dreams of mine together.
Mm. Yeah, and we have a question here from one of our guests. If you like animation more than painting, and why? So animation is your priority, not just paint, but to show all the story, to do animation from your paintings, right?
其实我不会去这样去比较他们，就是绘画它是最古老最基本的艺术形式，它也可以说是最成熟，虽然可能在大家眼里已经比较陈旧了。然后电影它是就是在现当代社会它是一个最有力量最主流的一个媒介，然后我觉得动画是把这两个东西结合在一起的。
I wouldn't really separate them or compare them this way. To me, painting is the most age-old and classic form of art, and the most matureAnd many people might think that it's a little bit too old. And we would believe that film is currently the most powerful medium for storytelling. And in animation, I can combine the two forms of art.
所以对我来说可能要可以放在一起说的是绘画和电影，他们的关系的结果是动画。
So if I have to say something about animation, then I would say that it's the result of painting plus film, a cinema. I wouldn't compare painting with animation. Yeah.
Okay. Hopefully our viewers are satisfied with this answer. I would like to speak a little bit about the situation that probably I'm wrong, but European and let's say American art world, they are kind of separated from Asian art world. Do you think that it is necessary to start more collaborations and to increase communication between these, let's say, two parts of the world, to work together, to exchange cultures?
我觉得是这样，就是现在的这种国与国之间交流的这种越来越多的障碍呢，它是一个政治环境，就是说我们作为艺术家其实是在被动接受这个环境的急剧的恶化。
I would put it this way, as artists, we are actually very passive in accepting the environment, and the environment is nowadays getting worse, more and more obstacles in the exchange and collaborations and communications between European, Americas and Asia.
然后就是就像我之前说我会选择去做艺术，其实就是因为拒绝我不满意的现实。那么其实现在的情况也是在发生一种我们不满意的现实。那我们只要我们还是主观上我们还是想交流的，就应该尽可能去克服困难，去继续这个交流。
So, like I said, the reason why I work in arts is because I want to get out of this situation. And I am trying to get out of this situation, but we are still in a very bad situation in communication, especially now.
就是我们应该尽可能去克服这个。
And although it's very difficult to do the communication, but as long as we like subjectively we are willing to talk, to exchange, we should do our best trying to get out.
Yeah, you are doing great job. And I'm really impressed with the list of the festivals where you were taking, participating in Vancouver, Stockholm, Rotterdam, and Venice soon coming, and Lugarno. And really, girls, you are doing a great job. And we are moving further to the, let's say, the final part of our interview. And I would like to answer, to ask you, do you have already a plan what you would do with the prize? If I could ask.
当然是用来做我的这个长篇项目了，就是它会很花钱，然后其实这个奖金大概会用来交房租。
So of course I will invest it in my feature film ongoing, because it is money. But this almost equals to I will use this money to pay my rent.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah,
okay. Because that's a big part of expense.
Okay. Yeah.
It's really helpful that Laguna offers this prize to us. We're really grateful.
I will remind to our guests that the prize is about 10,000 euro, and it's really worth to try to get it. Yeah, and that's fantastic that Yuan got it, and that's amazing, and all my congratulations to you. And the last question, what you would recommend to those artists who are just starting to think about participation in Arte Laguna Prize? Can you give some advices, some words of encouraging?
就是我想对准备要申请这个奖的艺术家说的是，既然你要申请的，那就尽可能认真准备，要求什么材料就认真的去做，但是不要太在意结果。
So here is what I have to say to artists that have the plan for applying Art Laguna Prize. If you decided to apply for the prize, then prepare as well, as thoroughly as you can. Get all the materials needed, just be really well prepared. But don't overly care about the results. Don't get tripped by the results.
因为我觉得呢，这个坚持你的创作和你坚持活着是一样的，就是这件事本身就应该是目的。你作为一个艺术家的存在本身就应该是目的。
So I believe that keeping on making art isn't much different from keeping on living, because the process itself is the purpose, and you being an artist is in itself the purpose.
那就是，我们不是为了去获得别人的认可才努力，而是我们就是继续做我们想做的事，这个事情本身其实就应该值得自豪。
We're not making effort to earn recognition from other people. We are doing this because being able to do what we want to do and keep doing it is in itself a great pride, I would say.
Wow, such a nice words, ladies. Thank you so much. I think it's so encouraging, even if you are not an artist, but just a person, to make your life this beautiful and enjoy the process and enjoy every hour, every day. It's a great message. Yeah, thank you so much. I wish you great luck in all your daily activities and all your festivals and feature films, all your artworks. And I invite everybody who are watching us now to follow Yuan Gao Instagram. Probably we can do it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, to continue, not to lose the connection. And we will post your Instagram on our social networks to get more followers to your pages, because the stories that you are telling us, that you are telling to the world, they are really very interesting, and we want to be in touch. We doesn't want to be separated by any viruses or borders. Let's be together, let's support each other. And I'm really very happy that no matter what lockdown happened in the world, we stay connected and we support each other. Thank you so much for this conversation, for this interview. And thanks to everyone who was with us during this online streaming. And I remind those artists who are just thinking to participate to use the option of pre-applications that you can do from website artalagunaprize.com and artalaguna.world. And thank you so much, ladies. Thank you, thank you, thank you, and good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you, Anna. Thank you.
Okay, good luck.
Good luck.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Good night.